जन्मभूमी कृष्ण जन्मभूमी आणि काशी विश्वेश्वर या स्थानांवर हिंदूंचाच अधिकार असून राम जन्मभूमीच्या जागेसंदर्भात सुरू असलेला खटला जिंकू असे राज्यसभा सदस्य अर्थतज्ञ सुब्रमण्यम स्वामी यांनी सांगितले आहे.
विश्वलीला ट्रस्टतर्फे अजिंक्य योद्धा श्रीमंत थोरले बाजीराव पेशवे यांच्या 319व्या जयंतीनिमित्त राज्यसभा सदस्य अर्थतज्ञ सुब्रमण्यम स्वामी यांच्या आर्थिक स्वातंत्र्य आव्हाने आणि संधी या विषयावरील व्याख्यानाचे आयोजन करण्यात आले होते. यावेळी पेशव्यांचे वंशज महेंद्र पेशवा, पुष्कर पेशवा, आमदार मेधा कुलकर्णी, आडेगाव येथील श्रीमंत बाजीराव पेशवा, सैनिक शाळेचे संस्थापक आबासाहेब कांबळे व वैशाली कांबळे, सीए रणजित नातू, मेजर जनरल संजय भिडे, विश्वलीला ट्रस्टचे देवव्रत बापट, प्रवीण जोशी, मोतीलाल ओसवाल, अक्षय गळसासी आदी उपस्थित होते. ते म्हणाले, आपल्याकडे साधन संपत्तीची कमतरता नाही, त्यामुळे आपण एखादी गोष्ट विकसित करू शकतो. भारतात अशी एकही समस्या नाही जी आपण सोडवू शकत नाही. फक्त आपण आपल्या देशातील लोकांना एखादी गोष्ट करण्यासाठी प्रोत्साहन देत नाही एवढेच. लोकांना नवनवीन गोष्टी करण्यासाठी प्रोत्साहित केले पाहिजेत. प्रत्येक वर्षी 10% प्रगती झाल्यास भारत विकसित देश होईल. त्यामुळे आर्थिकदृष्ट्या सक्षम झाल्यास आपला देश खऱ्या अर्थाने सक्षम होईल असंही ते म्हणाले. संयुक्त राष्ट्रसंघांना आव्हान देणारा फक्त आपला भारत देश आहे असे सांगत स्वातंत्र्यवीर सावरकरांना भारतरत्न देण्यासाठी नक्कीच प्रयत्न करणार असेही त्यांनी सांगितले. स्वामी म्हणाले, तिहेरी तलाक रद्द करण्याच्या निर्णयामुळे 50% अल्पसंख्याक समाज सरकारच्या पाठीशी आहे. तसेच 370 कलम रद्द केल्यामुळे जम्मू आणि काश्मीर देशाच्या मुख्य प्रवाहात आले आहे.
Price of rice is once basmati rice, for example, high quality rice is 1/6 that in Japan, 1/6 that in South Africa. Wheat is 1/4 that in United States. Milk is 1/6 or one fifth that in Europe. Milk we can produce in abundance. We got 150 million cows, feed them well, and you can get, today we are getting only 200 liters per year. And the Indian cow, which is called Bos Indicus, milk is now accepted in the United States and advanced countries as the most medically nutritious milk in the world. American breed is Bos Taurus. Nothing of that kind. It's only fat in it. But Indian Bos Indicus, our cow, its milk has got that value. And that's why if you now go to the United States in the supermarket, you'll see a separate can. It says A2 milk and in small print from cows from India. They have bottled it, packaged it, and they are now selling it in there. And it costs 4 times the price which the American cow's milk is being sold. We don't know the value of our own heritage. So therefore, we should now give focus to agriculture, not by giving them a loan waiver. That's not the way. Not by saying, okay, you don't have to pay taxes. What you have to do is empower them with fertilizer, new seeds is easy to get, and water, fertilizer, pesticide, packaging, marketing, export. Every district in our country should have a small airport like you find in countries like America. In America, every district for the farmer has an airport, a designated airport, which by which they can take it to market centers anywhere in the country. We need to export. So you need cold storages, you need packaging industries in the rural areas. All this will generate employment. You don't have to bribe the farmer. The farmer, you don't have to give him any dole subsidies. They can make enough because they are producing the cheapest in the world. And therefore, with this focus is necessary, not to appease him, not to get his vote or anything else. That way, Indian agriculture must get first priority. So our objective must be to grow at 10% per year. Can we grow at 10% per year? Of course we can grow. Who thought we will grow faster than 3.5% per year? We just deregulated this the economy and went to 7%, and he's remained all the time 7%. People say, "Oh, we're the largest growing country." That's not enough. 7% will not wipe out unemployment. 10% growth rate will wipe out unemployment. So therefore, I would like to say that aim for 10% growth rate. Give priority to agriculture and give priority to innovation. In every country which has grown fast, it has not been because of more capital and more labor. More capital and more labor will bring diminishing returns. As you put more and more capital and more labor into production, you will get more and more production, but the additional production will get smaller and smaller because of diminishing returns. So you will go around the curve which will bend that way. If you want to jump curves, then bring in new innovations. You have no water, desalinate seawater. You can produce any amount of water from the seas of India. And Israel has no rivers at all, but it is water.